Good afternoon to each and everyone. Let us pray and feel the presence of the Lord. Almighty Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for your unconditional love despite of our imperfection. Thank you for forgiving us our sins. Today, as I am going to have my oral defense, please continue to guide me. Grant me your knowledge and wisdom that I may execute my presentation very well. I offer all of this to you, O Lord. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Again, good afternoon po to each and everyone. My thesis title is Development and Validation of a Digital Grade 9 English Module. And to begin with, learning English as a subject is essential because it is the medium of instruction used in teaching other subjects. Once the student can comprehend the four macro skills in English, which is reading, writing, speaking, and listening, the student will enjoy his or her studies. Likewise, English as a second language is useful because it helps an individual to communicate both in oral and written communication. As it was mentioned by Wolf, language is not everything in education, but without language, everything is nothing in education. Significantly, language serves as the foundation of education. Therefore, in teaching learning process takes place if language is apprehended. In addition, Mukta 2013 mentioned that language is a feature of educational practice in the classroom. This means that in discussions of language and education, teachers and students use spoken and written language to communicate with each other. Students learn the academic written language and they learn the academic languages and literacies. Also, Tomlinson 2012 clarified that materials could be informative, instructional, experiential, eliciting, and exploratory. In teaching English as a discourse of academic disciplines, the teacher must be able to use the appropriate techniques or methods since there were or there are different learners who learn in various ways and styles. Another one, Kirkpatrick 2010, for English Language Teaching or ELT in the Philippines, he discussed that rather than focusing on a specific variety of English, the Philippines school curriculum needs to make a radical move to teach English used in social contexts within the region. That is why English language teaching in Philippines should consider the understanding of objects, words, emotions, and social cues because they may differ depending on where we encounter them and how they interpret in a certain place. As cited also by Samani and Zamanian 2018, for teachers of English, especially in the Philippines, the introduction of new language teaching approaches is always welcome as these add to the teacher's bag of tricks is embedded in the classroom. Actually, teachers or English teachers here in Philippines, they have the versatility in using different approaches or strategies. That is why they can develop an enthusiastic learner in classroom setting discussion. It was also stated by Sklepegrell and Olaron 2011, the three significant instructional aspects of this approach. Providing support for teachers vis-a-vis, how language works in their subject areas, B, careful unit planning, and C, scaffolding students' academic language and content learning simultaneously. These are the three significant strategies in instructional aspects because teachers are given the opportunity to develop or to evaluate the effectiveness of teaching the language and allowing the students to apply what they have taught. Correspondingly, teacher adds support for students in order to evaluate learning and aid in the mastery of tasks. So for Kayun 2011, he perceived the leadership role and of the English language teacher in school programs to support students learning the alternative English subject across the curriculum. In making the approaches and techniques effective, a language teacher will take his or her part in reorganization of the traditional curriculum and suggests the maximized learning opportunities of the students to meet the alternative English subject across the curriculum. Another one, A.E. Lindsay 2010 and Cummings 2011 confirmed the importance of literacy engagement in predicting student literacy outcomes, which are possible to be more functioning in a context that builds student perception of their literacy competence. Literacy engagement should take into consideration that learners can comprehend social context communication. In that way, we can see how effective is our outcome, how effective is our approaches or strategies in teaching learning process. Next, Grazer, McNamara, and Kulikowicz 2011 mentioned that unpacking the multiple associates among language features, example given vocabulary, grammar, text cohesion, poses an intellectual challenge to the English language learner, listener, or reader. These are just only a few of the difficulties met by the learners in studying English as a subject. That is why teachers should also give focus and guide the learners in enhancing the vocabulary and grammar of the learners. Next, Solanki and Shamlil 2012. Alternatively, due to the entry of technology, English language teaching changed considerably. It offers a lot of benefits as making upskill motivating and more prolific in terms of innovations. Teaching should not be confined in the mastery of the four macro skills. There is also a shift in innovative learning. Also, Cosley 2014 stated that technology is a compelling contributor to learning if wielded to deepen learners partake in a meaningful and authentic curriculum. This is because it can create a functional and unique curriculum where learners will be exposed in manipulating new technology approaches. With this, Jilagjani 2017 said that the teachers must model the application of equipment in support of the curriculum so that learners can see the correct use of expertise and benefit from disclosure to more enhanced applications that they will execute independently in the future. Teachers must also know how to teach and using the and perform the technology so that they can encourage the students the benefits of innovative learning in the future. Lynn said that it is the typical obligation for educators to become more resourceful, empower students to learn, and foster the new generation with imaginative and balanced technologies and critical thinking with technologies and complex information in the present era. In addition, as an educators, we must help the new generations or students to have the realization of their creativity and logical reasoning in embracing the use of technology in academic learning. So Bia et al. Found that the students' difficulties as described by the teachers are related to grammar, pronunciation, vocabulary, linguistic devices such as rhyme scheme, alliteration, assonance, consonance, syllable, diphthong, and diagram. Our students encounter different difficulties. Nonetheless, even the students are exposed in using the technology, there are still difficulties need to be enhanced and need to remediate, such as grammar, pronunciation, vocabulary, and linguistic devices. Additionally, JEDUL 2013, in an open distance and learning, or ODL, the students face many barriers, including lack of English proficiency, and they play poor writing skills. So this time, it is not only in the traditional learning modality that several difficulties are met by our learners. Even in open and distance learning modality, our students have also their lack of English proficiency and poor writing skills. Therefore, the learner cannot express themselves and cannot comprehend verbal and non-verbal communication. Lastly, Jacob 2019 stated that learning a second language is never easy. Mainly, learning English, especially if you are in an outside of an English-speaking country, will surely be hard. Because you are not, as a Filipino learner, you are not a native speaker or student. So it takes a lot of practice and mastery, similar to learning English as a subject area. Algam G 2017, unsurprisingly, mentioned that the web is the communication medium of choice for advanced modern education systems where distance learning fast become the most widespread and efficient method of delivering course material, studying, and sharing information. Actually, with regard to the present situation of education, it is timely to create and produce instructional modules to continue the learning of the learners and meet their needs in developing their skills. That is why involving modern education systems like technology integration in a teaching learning process become rampant and available for use in studying and disseminating knowledge and information. Also, Holzberger et al. 2013 viewed digital learning as delivery with electronic types of media, example given text or pictures via the internet, and the created instructional contents and teaching designs were to augment learners' learning and aim to maintain teaching efficacy or stimulate personal knowledge and skills. With the use of digital learning as an instructional materials, students are motivated and eager to engage themselves in learning and can become skilled in technology. Also, Lai et al. 2012 mentioned that practical teaching strategies are developed by combining current literacy trends and extracting the advantages of digital learning to achieve wisdom effectiveness. It is in the application or implementation of literacy trends to actual or constructive teaching approaches where students have a successful learning during the teaching learning process. In addition, Stanto 2017 said that this development is measured by the extent of educators' virtuosity of teaching methods with current teaching strategies. This is because effective teachers are known by their great skill in teaching. And for the theoretical framework of this research study, here is the Brunner constructivism theory. The theory is focused to a learner-centered where students are embracing the knowledge and carefully change and develop their own comprehension, which is beyond the information provided. Thus, the teacher allows the learners to discover learning styles by themselves. The paradigm of the study, first, here is the input, wherein series of lessons and activities will develop the competencies of the grade 9 learners. Next, we have the process. The process will be the evaluation of the module by two sets of experts. These experts will determine how will the module be evaluated in terms of content, format, technical, and pedagogy. Lastly, the output, which will be the grade 9 English module to be uploaded in a digital platform. For the research problems, generally this study aimed to develop and validate an English digital module for grade 9 students in one of the public schools in Angeles City, Pampanga during the school year 2020 to 2021. Specifically, it aimed to answer the following questions. How may the English digital module for grade 9 students be designed? Number two, how may the English digital module for grade 9 students be validated in terms of A, content? And for the content, generally, this discussed the topic correspondent with the definite objects, relevant and sufficient information, appropriate and comprehended language. Knowledge that will meet and sustain the needs and level of the learners. In addition, all of the references and links used in here are provided for the research activities. Letter B, design or format. Substantially, this part is concerned to the appearance of the text, including appropriate spacing, properly labeled topics, and clear directions that will affect the presentation of the textual information of the module. And letter C, technical or technological, wherein the digital module does not require equipment or applications beyond what is typically available to the students. And lastly, the pedagogy. Primarily, this part is focused on the precise and systematic objectives, proper assessments of the prior knowledge, various strategies and instructional approaches and activities that are fit to learners' level and applicable to the main objectives of the course and considered in the competencies of the grade 9 learners. And for the methods, the research design, the current study employed design and development research which is based on the concept that the practice of design and development is empirical by nature. Richie Klein, 2007. The evaluators, there were two sets of evaluators for the proposed digital grade 9 modules in English. The first set of evaluators comprises one English ed teacher, one school principal, one subject teacher, and one English critic. They were responsible for evaluating the content of the module. On the other hand, the second set of the evaluators consists of three ICT experts who scrutinize the format of the module. The instrument of this study was decided to the validity and acceptability of the grade 9 English digital module. The researcher utilized the evaluation instrument for topics to be included in the digital education or the DE, online digital e-learning or ODL module and evaluation rating sheet for DE and ODL provided by the College of Education of the Pampanga State Agricultural University. The evaluation tool comprises the following criteria: content, design or format, technical and pedagogy. In terms of the content, validity of the topics, a checklist validation sheet with essential and not essential topics was utilized. For the procedures, there are two phases. First is the development phase. In the development phase, the English digital module was based on the competencies of grade 9 K-12 curriculum guide, and this includes the different macro skills, listening comprehension, reading comprehension, grammar awareness, vocabulary development, and reading comprehension. After that, a checklist validation was given to experts in the field to determine the acceptability of the proposed module. Then the researcher delved, reviewed, and compiled all the lessons under the wing of the grade 9 K-12 curriculum guide. The second phase is the validation phase, wherein the evaluation tool was composed of the following criteria: content, design or format, technical and pedagogy, with a total of 22 items. In terms of the content validity of the subjects, a checklist validation sheet with essential and not essential topics were utilized. It was validated by the three validators: one English ed teacher, one school principal, one English major, and one English critic to check the validity of the digital module. After that, the evaluation instrument for topics to be included in the digital education or online digital e-learning module and evaluation rating sheet for DE and ODL, answerable by yes or no, was provided by the College of Education. For the results and discussions of the findings, Table 1, development of a digital grade 9 English module. This digital grade 9 English module underwent three stages, and the first stage is planning and design, wherein the researcher identified the competencies of grade 9 K-12 curriculum guide, followed by stage 2, development of the module. This is the overview of the module, wherein the validators had a checklist evaluation tool for essential and not essential topics, which will be included in the digital grade 9 module. Third will be the stage 3 validation of the module, wherein the evaluators will be given evaluation rating sheet for DE and ODL modules answerable by yes or no. It has four factors: factor 1, content; factor 2, design or format; factor 3, technical or technological; factor 4, pedagogy; and lastly, the fourth stage, and after that, minor grammar errors and other concerns were corrected. Lastly, final design of the lesson and final production of the digital module were made. For table 2.1, content validity of the number of respondents indicating essential. So in here, topics included were assessed by the evaluators. And based from the findings, table 2.1, shows the ratio of the number of respondents indicating essential for the topics which were used in the development of the digital grade 9 modules. Based on the evaluation of the validators, the following topics using literary devices, mechanics, capitalization, and punctuation, journalistic writing, literary writing, using interjections, word order in English sentences, sequence signals, persuasive text, elements of prose fiction, conditional sentences, kinds of adverbs, verbals, infinitives, participles, gerunds, using active and passive voices of verbs and modals, had a content validity ratio of 1, described as essential, indicating that the topics were necessary for the digital module. Other topics including making inferences, subject-verb agreement rules, sensory images, drama, structure, type, performance, and reported speech got a content validity ratio of 0.87 labeled as essential. Also, literary selections, Seven Ages of Man, Beowulf, Mother to Son, literary selections, Auld Lang Syne, The Man with the Hoe, The Telephone, Romeo and Juliet, Dreams Deferred, A Raisin in the Sun, Death of a Salesman, and literary devices obtained a content validity ratio of 0.73 considered essential for the digital module. Lastly, skimming and scanning acquired a content validity ratio of 0.60, which regarded as essential, which were useful for the digital module. Thus, these topics were utilized to meet the competencies of the K-12 Curriculum Guide for English 9. For the second table, table 2.2.1, content validation of the digital grade 9 module. So here, it was revealed that on the first validation, one of the four evaluators did not agree in statement 1.5. The knowledge and ideas being presented in every unit are accurate, recent, and free from errors, using technologies that suit the distinct characteristic of the target learners. On the second validation, the four evaluators anonymously agreed that the material met the standards from statements 1.1 to 1.5. This means that on the first validation, there were still areas on the material that needed to be improved, as suggested by the evaluators, such as minor grammatical editing in some sections before the final utilization of the module, and limited number of questions should be observed among the reading selection given. For the next table, table 2.2.2, design or format validation of the grade 9, design of the grade 9 module. On the first validation, results show that all evaluators already agreed that the digital module met the standards from statements 2.1 to 2.5. The result implies that the digital module complied with all the parameters based on the standard evaluation tool prescribed by the institution. Next, table 2.2.3, technical or technological validation of the digital grade 9 module, wherein ICT experts are the validators. In here, the result presented that on the first validation, the four ICT validators already agreed that the digital modules, that the digital module satisfied all the set parameters for technical or technological aspect of the digital module. In addition, the evaluators also mentioned the graphics and illustrations were vividly presented. Therefore, the second validation was not needed. And lastly, Table 2.2.4, Pedagogy Validation of the Grade 9 Module. It shows here that on the first validation, the four validators already agreed with all the statements. This indicated that the activities connect students' language with literacy and content area knowledge through speaking, listening, reading, and writing activities, which encourages students to use content vocabulary to express themselves. Therefore, the competencies which were presented in the digital module provide frequent opportunity for students to interact with each other and the teacher during the instructional activities. Hence, the material met all the standards and is reliable up to the final validation. For the conclusion of this study, based on the results of the study, the following conclusions are drawn. First, the digital grade 9 English module underwent planning and design stage, development stage, and evaluation stage. The content was based on the curriculum guide prescribed by the Department of Education and target the competencies needed by grade 9 learners from first grading to fourth grading. Second, the digital grade 9 English module met all the standards after editing and revisions were done and can be uploaded in learning management system like Google Classroom. For the recommendations of the study, considering the aforementioned findings and conclusions, the following recommendations are hereby suggested. First, the Department of Education or DepEd should provide training and seminars to secondary English teachers to enhance their ideas and skills in producing efficient instructional materials. And second, the digital grade 9 English module may be adapted by DepEd to serve as a teaching material which can be used in blended instruction. That ends my presentation. Thank you so much for listening.